That musically recently I've been so drawn to the sun and the cosmos and, you know, and connecting my sound with nature and with other forces and other beings, and I just wanted to be somewhere very quiet in my spare time, and so I can really connect with the beauty that we have around us. Decided that just 30, 40 minutes away from the centre of Florence is this beautiful part of the Mugello region, and in the middle of absolute nowhere, no neighbours, and I found this beautiful farmland, which used to be an old church and an old monastery, and the priest used to live up here, and the church was at the bottom of the hill. There's something very, very grounding about getting up in the morning and going down my little basket and picking tomatoes and zucchinis off and pulling potatoes and onions out of the ground. I mean, it's literally farm to table right here in a few steps, you know. So we're completely self-sufficient here. We have chickens and ducks and goats, not that I'd eat those, but they're our friends. Nowadays, I think that I've done so much that it's nice to actually like spend a bit more time on myself right now. You know, the past few years I've been working so hard for other people, you know, helping to bring up some other people's careers and help develop artists and concentrate. That's not to say that I'm not doing that now, but I've just realised in the past couple of years that actually, you know, maybe I should just like take some time for myself for a little bit. And that was the moment when I started to make the new album. It's largely a collection of music I've discovered from the far reaches of the earth, you know, musicians and artists and talented people that don't necessarily come from house and techno or the electronic world, for that matter. Hence working with Qawwali singers from Karachi, or prepared pianists from New York, or Egyptian percussionists. Sometimes you come across, you know, quite a lot of narrow-minded people in house and techno, in that they only like, you know, focus in on that music. And I feel that there's so much to be learned and experienced from like the bigger picture. I mean, I still absolutely adore DJing. I still have like so much motivation to do. I very, very rarely kind of get to the party and like don't feel like I want to play, or I'm too tired to do it. You know, even if I'm tired, I still have this kind of like autopilot thing that kind of takes over, and like reminds me what I'm doing and how important it is. So even if there's just like three people in the audience that are like really in tune with me and like really hanging on every tune I'm about to play, I can potentially inspire those three people or 3,000 people, you know, to wake up the following morning and, you know, switch on their, you know, machines and make the next wave of amazing music. And, you know, for me, I've always been about creating like special moments, you know, and memories for people and for myself as well. I think that that's what I kind of tend to strive for, you know. And now with the band, you know, I want to try and encapsulate all these magical moments in like 1 hour, in a 1 hour show with these musicians and, you know, trying something new. And, you know, this is a whole new ball game for me now, being in the band. A little while ago, I started to develop some kind of odd cosmic, aura that connected me to the right parties with the right music at the right time, and something happened, and I started to become what I am now, and I noticed it happening, but I tried not to make too much of a thing about it, and it kind of just transformed in the way that I dress and, you know, the people I'd hang out with and the way that I'd find myself like moving when I was playing, and it just all came together, you know, for me. You know, when you kind of combine that with the places that I feel most comfortable DJing at, you know, in the desert or in the forest or up a mountain or somewhere underground, you know, it's like, right, okay, so I've got all these elements and these natural elements around, and like I'm dealing with this music which is almost like from another world, and, you know, so I'm not going to be that guy behind the laptop just not moving and just like, you know, pressing a few buttons and like not looking like they're enjoying themselves. And it just feels totally natural to be me. So I think there just came a moment when I just started to get really comfortable with who I am as a person, and then it just came out in my music.